Hello and welcome. In the last couple of videos I uploaded, they were about the details of how I installed the solar panels and the electrical system and the inverters and batteries into my travel trailer. It's a 2019 Lance 2185. Now, one thing that I hadn't quite installed yet when I made those videos was a surge suppression type device to protect it in the case of a disaster in the future, like a lightning strike, for instance. If we were camping out in an open area, lightning strikes are quite likely. And then there's also the potential, which is less likely, but we are currently in the cycle of the sun, where the coronal mass ejections or solar flares are more likely to happen. And then there's also the whole war going on in Eastern Europe and the potential for an EMP. Now, I don't think that's very probable at this point in time, but this device protects from all of those. So to me, it's kind of a no-brainer to go ahead and install it just to protect it. And when I say protect it, I mean like this trailer and its electrical system isn't just for the trailer. It's also for my brick and mortar house. If the electrical grid goes down, I can plug my trailer into the house and power my house from the trailer. It's not at the same level of amps as what the grid can supply, but it still is plenty for us to be able to run our essential devices and even some non-essential devices. So to me, protecting my RV's electrical system is important because it's my backup mechanism for my whole house, and it's for the RV itself if we happen to be out somewhere. You know, I've spent a fair amount of money invested in the equipment that I've built out into this trailer, and I figured adding a little bit more money to protect that is important, so I should probably do so. Now, the device that I chose to install is this right here. This is from the company called EMP Shield, and this is their version that is for 120 and 240 volts. You can see right there it says SP120240, and the RL on the name of the model number stands for remote lead, and that's this right here. That's the indicator that shows that line 1 and line 2 are protected. And it has 12 gauge wire on the side that's coming out of the side of it. And looking down here, you can see some of the specs of this particular device. Now, if you have a system that is, say, only a 12 volt system that then has an inverter 220 volt system, you would only need two devices, one for the 120 volts and one for the 12 volts. Because these devices, the EMP shield, monitors the voltage and then shunts it to ground, it has to be monitoring it for a specific voltage range. And so you can't just have one device that just protects all of the different types of electricity on board your travel trailer, at least in my case. EMP Shield sells a whole bunch of different devices, a whole slew of them for various solutions. And so I have one here that is for the AC system on the house, or on the trailer. And then over here in this box, I actually have a couple of other devices. This is for the 24 volt part of the system. This is the batteries are in 24 volt configuration. This is for the solar panel array coming off of the roof. And then over here, this is for the 12 volt system. And then this here is for the truck. Generally, the way the EMP shield works is it basically is just monitoring the voltage of the circuit that it's on, and the different EMP shields are designed for different circuit voltages. And if it detects a spike in voltage, then in just milliseconds, it locks down on that and shuts off the system so that there won't be any spike in the voltage that will burn out your components ultimately. And this is rated to be able to work good enough for the military, and so it's very high-end quality components. I have partnered with EMP Shield, and if you are interested in getting $50 off per device of your own EMP Shield device for brick-and-mortar house or travel trailers or vehicles, feel free to enter in the coupon code of Dunster, and that will give you $50 off. I'm now going to get these installed, and then I'll show you what they look like when they're done. It does come with these instructions for the various different devices. This one happens to be the one that's meant for solar panels, and it has some other instructions in here for the different types of ones, like if you're installing it in a vehicle, for instance. In this video, I'm not trying to go into details of exactly how to install this device. You can go watch other YouTube videos for that. I'm just going to show you kind of how it worked out in my particular trailer and how I had to get it, how I had to install them to have it cover all the different components of my system. Here's the finished installation. You can see one EMP shield right there, the other one over there, and then there are two right here. So let's go through these and I'll just show you how I hooked them up. This one right here has two indicator lights on it, and that is because it's a dual model unit that is going to both of the charge controllers. And so there are actually five wires coming out of it. One of them is a ground wire. It's going down to this grounding bus bar. And actually all of them have a grounding wire because that's how this device works. And then there are two sets of negative and positive wires. So this is one of the positive wires, and this is one of the negative wires, and they are in parallel going into the PV inputs here on this charge controller. And then it works the same way over here on the PV. There's one positive here, and the other negative one is right here, so those are in parallel. And I connected them into a larger ferrule for two wires, and then used that ferrule to go into that PV input. So anyway, that's how that's put together. And then of course, just it's mounted here, just screwed to the wall right there. So it works perfectly in that spot. I couldn't put more down below it. I kind of wanted to, it's a little bit cramped, but mainly there's no way for a screwdriver to screw in these screws right here for anything below here, but here I could access those screws. Okay, so then let's just jump over here to this one. This one also fits nicely and it's nicely symmetrical as well. This one is for the 24 volt system. So basically the wires are coming out of it. There's three of them. One's a ground wire that's going to the same grounding bus bar over there. And then it has the positive wire here onto that and the negative here onto this bus bar, which of course goes across all that. And that's all energized in 24 volt. And that's that EMP shield there is protecting the link shunt and the circuitry in there, and then the BMSs that are inside of all of these battle borne batteries, and also potentially, I guess, the 24 volt side of the step down converter that steps down from 24 to 12 volts. And that one as well is just screwed in there into the wall and fits quite nicely, and it has an on indicator light right there. Okay, so then over here we have two more. The one here on the left is the 12 volt EMP shield. And so that one has wires that are going over here to my 12 volt bus bar. It's a sub bus bar that is just for the 24 volt system. And so that is protecting everything in the trailer that is 12 volts. And then the indicator light shows that it's working. And then last but not least is this one right here. And this is the dual 120 volt and 240 volt EMP shield. And so that one has a remote indicator light. So that's this ribbon right here. Is that coming down this way? And then this is the remote indicator that it's protecting those circuits. Now, right now it's powered off because I have turned off the inverters for the evening. Otherwise, those lights would be on. And those are coming in here to this. Here's the inside of that AC distribution panel, and these are the two wires coming in right here, and the black is one of the hot positives, and then the red is the other hot, and then there are also grounding wires and white, the common lines that are coming in here. So we have the common bus bar and then the grounding bus bar over here, and then the two hots are coming down here to this circuit breaker, and they are piggybacked onto this one with the EV charging circuit, and I just leave that on all the time. In order for the EMP shield to work, the breaker it's connected to has to always be on, so I have to make sure I do that, otherwise it won't be protected if I flick that off. One additional advantage to the EMP shield for a brick and mortar home that is connected to the power grid is that if that power grid were to experience a cyber attack, they could potentially raise the voltage of the grid and fry all of the devices in your house prior to actually bringing the grid completely down. So in this case, if you install an EMP shield on your house, it protects you from that as well as all of the other things that I mentioned previously. I decided to go ahead and install one here on my house, and so I wanted to show you what that installation looks like. So a 20 amp double pole breaker is what you're supposed to use to install it, and it's inside, and then the remote lead is coming out, and I have it stuck right here with double-sided tape that it comes with to show that the line 1 and line 2 are protected. They do have a device where the indicator lights are on it, just like my other ones, and then they have the remote lead version like this where you can bring it out. So I just wanted to show you briefly what that looks like on my house. And here is the installation on my truck. So conveniently, there was an open spot right here, and the EMP shield comes with double-sided sticky tape on the back of it. And I don't know how well you can see that right there in that gap, though. You can see it's Velcro, and so it's double-sided sticky tape and then Velcro, and then it's stuck to the back of the EMP shield. So it's stuck there very firmly, and then out of it is coming these three wires. The green is obviously ground, and then you have the red is positive and the black is negative. And those go to the corresponding locations. So here I have a red on the positive terminal. Over here we have black on the negative terminal. And then back here is where the ground is going to the chassis of the vehicle. So this in theory will protect it in the case of an overvoltage situation. It also comes with an inline fuse right here. It's a 20 amp fuse that goes right there. All of these devices were relatively simple to install, and so it's not that hard to DIY. And I hope it's been helpful to see what I was able to do and in the context and where I used it. And if you are interested in getting some of the EMP shields for yourself, use my discount code of Dunster for $50 off. And with that, I will see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Speedy fast Clara.